Welcome back to Tamano Perspective. I have with me today Aurora Representative Sunny Angara and IBP President Attorney Roan De Barrios. Thank you so much for taking the time to come here.
Thank you also for inviting us.
I know you guys are going to be very busy.
Yeah, yeah. Thanks a lot, Adele. Good evening, President Roan.
Good evening. Yeah. Good evening, Congressman Angara and future Senator of the Land.
Well, we'll get to that later. But let's start with you, Roan. You're president of the IBP.
Yes.
You've taken quite a strong stand on this impeachment, essentially saying that it undermines judicial independence. Yeah.
Because of the nature of the charges being collegial decisions of the Supreme Court.
Okay.
We are bothered by the nature of the charges because they involve not the decisions of the CJ, but the decisions itself of the Supreme Court. And we feel that even the Ateneo Law Alumni Association said that it violates the separation of powers.
All right. So your view is that the attack is not just on the Chief Justice personally, but on the entire Supreme Court.
Because of the nature of the charges being collegial decisions. We have no problem kung yung atake involving the ill-gotten wealth.
Okay.
Kung may mga problema sa bribery. Okay. Wala problema dun eh. Ang problema ng IBP is on the nature of the charges being collegial decisions. Like for example, the charges on the unconstitutionality, for example, the Truth Commission, EO number 2, the TRO, and many other decisions of the Supreme Court which are not considered as culpable violation of the Constitution. Now, these are decisions of the Supreme Court, and there are no allegations therein that there was bribery in the decision, that the decision was accompanied by any illegal consideration.
Okay.
And so practically, even judges are supposed to enjoy wide latitude. They cannot be removed on the basis of an erroneous decision or a mistake in the judgment based on their appreciation of the facts and evidence. In this particular case, I think some of the decisions there were based on how the Supreme Court appreciated the facts, how the Supreme Court appreciated the rulings in the previous cases, and the decision and the existing constitution. And since there is no allegation of any corrupt motive, any allegation of bribery, it is very difficult for the IBP to accept that these decisions can be considered as grounds for the removal of any justice of the Supreme Court. That is why, even if it is not the Chief Justice who is on trial here, kahit sinong justice, kung ganong klaseng proseso ang nangyari, no, na halos wala nangyaring due process sa House, and if the grounds refer to collegial decisions without any other additional allegations of bribery or improper motives, then the IBP will still make the same position.
Okay. Sunny, obviously, as spokesman for the prosecution, you have a different view. So let's hear it.
Yeah. Well, with due respect to my panyero, who I respect very much.
Who happens to be your IBP president.
That's right. That's right. We're all, and yours too. we feel that, you know, we're not, it's not a personal attack on, it's not an institutional attack rather, but rather it's a, the charges are very peculiar to the Chief Justice.
Okay.
The allegations of partiality stem from circumstances which are very personal to the Chief Justice. His closeness to the President and his closeness with his wife to the President, the various back scratching that we've seen in various aspects over the years, interaction with litigants, that's very personal to him. And we've accepted the fact that these decisions are part of the law of the land. They are part of our jurisprudence. And by no means do we seek to overturn them.
Okay, so you're not questioning these decisions, but rather Chief Justice Corona's personal participation in these decisions.
His personal participation, his decisions, and the reasons for acting on them, I think these are all part and parcel. His failure to file his salen and his wealth, I think these are all peculiar to him. And do not involve the other justices at all.
Okay. You're a lawyer, Sunny, and there are a lot of lawyers in Congress. This has been raised by the defense, and for me also, I think it's a valid point. Why the need for private prosecutors? Why don't you guys handle it yourself?
Well, lawyers are a dwindling breed, actually, in Congress. I think there used to be about 60, 70, 80. Now there are about 30 in Congress. But you were involved in the Estrada impeachment, and there was the participation of some very notable, including Attorney Bautista, who's now helping us. And I think it's permitted by the Senate rules. So I think for me that's a settled issue, but others may have a different view.
But the counter argument is that impeachment is a sovereign act. It's not it's not merely something that you can entrust to a private prosecutor, because when the articles of impeachment are sent to the Senate, these are actually supposedly is an act of the legislature itself. And hence, it should be legislators who will prosecute it.
Well, you have to understand, Adele, that congressmen don't practice law on a daily basis.
Okay.
So, kumbaga, hindi kami boxingero. We are celebrity boxers once in a while. We have celebrity boxing tournaments, di ba? Okay. Unlike our counterparts, every day, day in, day out, they're in the courts practicing their trade. So, okay, you know, it's hindi patas yata, di ba? Pagka we don't have these people. And the important principle, I think, Adele, is that these private prosecutors are under the control and supervision of the public prosecutor, congressman.
Okay.
We have no objections from the IBP.
Okay.
On the hiring of private prosecutors.
It's livelihood for the lawyers.
No objection. Being paid. I'm curious.
No.
So it's not really livelihood. There's no payment. Is it true that you have 10 law firms
helping actually
you?
No law firms, because it's just individuals helping us.
And how many are they?
Like
how
even
many?
Attorney Mario Bautista, he belongs to a very prominent law firm, but he's only helping in his individual
how
capacity.
Many lawyers are helping you?
I don't have the exact number, Adele, because what we've done is we've split up the congressman prosecutors into various teams. So 8 lead prosecutors for the 8 articles of impeachment. And I would say at each congressman prosecutor has about 1 or 2 helping him. So possibly more. Yeah.
Okay. Ron, for you, I want you to clear up this criticism because people are saying that the IBP is protecting the Chief Justice. And since there is that allegation that the Chief Justice is connected to GMA, that effectively the IBP is actually protecting the interests of GMA. How would you react to this type of criticism?
This is not the first time that the IBP issued a statement against impeachment.
Okay.
During the time of Chief Justice Davide, the IBP even went as far as filing a petition in the Supreme Court.
Yes.
To challenge the impeachment of then Chief Justice Davide. In this case now, the IBP has refused to file any petition.
That's right.
Against the impeachment.
Although you had a former IBP.
Yeah, we had a former IBP. In fact, this morning, Alan Paguia and Bono Adasal ambassaded us for our refusal to intervene in the Supreme Court proceedings, despite our observation that the process was not properly adhered to.
Okay.
Yung buong proseso.
Okay.
But we have said that the IBP has taken a position as an advocate of the rule of law. It will have to point out the defects in the procedure that were not followed. Or if the procedures in the Constitution and the procedures in the rules of the House are not were not followed, then the IBP has to speak out.
Okay.
Being an advocate of the rule of law.
So
this
how,
is not
how
a stand for Corona. This is a stand for the rule of law.
So how will the IBP participate or perhaps intervene in the current proceedings?
We have organized an IBP impeachment watch.
Okay. What's the purpose?
It will closely monitor and observe the proceedings in the Senate. This was organized last month, no? And we will field lawyers in the Senate to come up with observations, monitor the trial, and then probably inform the public and digest to the public the importance of the proceedings.
Okay.
And we want the process to also proceed. We have not filed any case to stop the proceedings in the Senate. And we want the trial to proceed. That has been the stand already of the IBP.
All right. Sunny, another Sunny has been called to the Senate to testify. Speaker Belmonte, the defense has filed a motion to have him subpoenaed and to essentially testify, most likely in regard to verification, verification of the impeachment complaint. What is your stand on this? Can the Senate compel him to come or will he voluntarily go?
I can't really give a committed answer to that, Adele, at this stage because I think they're still discussing it.
Okay.
The speaker is still deciding what to do. I personally feel it's not necessary because, you know, this is the transmission of the impeachment complaint is an official act of Congress.
Okay.
And, you know, the usual practice is for the Senate and the House to trust the official acts of the other. You know, if the House said that, you know, this is the impeachment complaint, it's signed by 188 congressmen, it has been verified by 188 congressmen, I don't think we need to look beyond that. I think we should proceed to the merits of the case because many commentators, yourself included, have said that impeachment is kind of an extreme case. You know, it must be decided. It must be somewhat summary.
Yes.
It can't drag on for a long time because it's an acknowledgement that there are there are problems with it in the sense that it detracts from people doing their regular jobs. It's not the regular course of business. It's somewhat unusual in that sense. Like the Senate, it takes away time from their legislative, and the Chief Justice for himself, for his part, will be somewhat distracted also because from his duties in the court. Because then I'm sure he'll be monitoring his trial. So,
okay. Since we're touching on the issue, Roan, of the nature of the impeachment process, I have seen the prosecution trying to paint the process as more political. Would you agree with that it is essentially a purely political process, or do you have another view of what the process of impeachment is?
The impeachment process is political only because it is being undertaken by the political departments of the government. Okay. It is Congress and the Senate.
Yes.
They're undertaking the process of the impeachment. But the impeachment process is also a constitutional mechanism.
Okay.
So therefore, it must follow the constitutional processes. And it must be guided by the established constitutional norms and principles, such as due process, fair play, and judgment based on the evidence and judgment based on the merits of the case. And even the Senate Rules on Procedure on the impeachment speaks of impartial administration of justice.
Okay.
In the House Rules, it also speaks of the criminal procedure being supplitory in character.
Okay.
So in other words, there is an adherence to the judicial process. Recognition that the impeachment proceedings is not completely political. It is only political because it is being undertaken by the political departments. But it's also judicial and constitutional because it is provided for in the Constitution, and therefore it must adhere to the constitutional processes of due process, equal protection of the law, fair play, and a judgment that is based on the merits and based on the evidence.
I'll give you something a little bit related to that, or very much related to that. There was some allegations in regard a Bellagio condominium, etc. The defense essentially were saying that it's not included in the articles of impeachment. Can you comment on that?
There is some difficulty, no? Because that I do not know if that's particularly reflected in the complaint. Because in the original complaint, the prosecution merely stated that the Chief Justice failed to disclose his SALN.
Yes.
In other words, failure to file the SALN. That was the main articles of impeachment. Now, later on, madaming lumalabas na ngayon ng mga allegations about ang dami palang property daw ni Chief Justice, which of course the CJ is also denying, no? And is claiming that it's part of the SAL yung ibang properties. So, but I think in the interest of transparency, regardless of the rules, I think the Chief Justice should explain.
Okay.
Now, that's my position.
Okay. Now, Sonny, I'm going to ask you a political question.
Sure.
All right, since we're talking about politics. Your father, obviously, known as a senator, incumbent senator, and you are one of the spokesmen.
That's right.
Is he going to inhibit himself, since you are obviously a spokesman for the prosecution?
Well, I can't speak for him, you know. I haven't spoken to him for a while, especially about the impeachment. I've been keeping my distance.
So your Sunday lunches,
regular Sunday lunches.
Ah, okay.
Because
okay.
He travels around the country, so,
okay.
The last time I saw him was over the Christmas holiday.
Okay.
So, but I can say a number of things in relation to that question, Adele.
Okay.
Is firstly, my father and I, in my brief political career, we've been really independent of each other. During the impeachment of Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, we took separate positions.
Okay.
During the Hello Garci tapes, we took separate positions. During the debates on the value-added tax, we took different positions. So I don't think that assumption is somewhat flawed if people are assuming that because I'm here, he's going to take my side. I think we've proven over the past few years that we have taken different sides on many issues.
Okay.
And secondly, I was offered to be a prosecutor, Adele.
Okay.
And because, like you said, there are not many lawyers in the house.
That's
and
right.
And I specifically did not accept that. The house elects you, and I did not accept it because
so
I felt that
it
would be difficult if I would be presenting evidence and speaking to the senators, in front of the senators. That'd be difficult. But on the role of spokesperson, I feel, is relatively harmless because you're just a messenger. You're just the deliverer of news.
Okay. Well, actually, some would say that it's kind of sneaky what the prosecution has done, that they have appointed spokespeople because there's under the new rules of the Senate, prosecutors, witnesses, resource persons, the impeached official, and the senators cannot speak publicly about the merits.
Yes.
Now, do you fall under this prohibition as a spokesman?
Well, we don't want to take such a black and white line. In fact, what we're doing going forward is we're avoiding speaking on the merits, actually, because we feel that we don't want the Senate to earn the ire of the senators.
Okay, so you don't see it as a loophole. So, which means that come impeachment trial time, you will not be speaking on the merits. None of the spokesmen will speak on the merits.
I think you can speak on it once it's out there. I don't think you can preempt the Senate. But if for example, we can describe what happened on the Senate floor, I think that's relatively innocuous. You
know? Yeah, but description and the weight of what is presented. Will the spokesman be willing to discuss the weight and the sufficiency of the evidence that's presented?
I would think so. I would think that's part of the education of the public in general. You know, impeachment is not, it's often said it's sui generis, you know.
Okay.
It's not your regular trial where cameras are forbidden.
Okay.
In fact, many people think it should be covered because it's the public's case. So I think we tread the fine line. We don't want to preempt what's going to happen on the Senate floor. But I don't think I don't think the rules are meant to preempt us from commenting on the case.
Okay. Yeah. President Roan, obviously this is a unique case.
Yes, sir.
Particularly unique because the president himself has pushed for this case. Now, do you believe, given that context and given the high popularity of President Aquino, that the Chief Justice will actually be given a fair trial?
We hope that the Chief Justice can be given a fair trial. But we share your observation, because normally the impeachment is a tool of the opposition.
Okay.
That is why it is required 1/3 they override. No? It's actually a tool for the opposition. But here we have an impeachment that is becoming a tool of the administration. So we must be careful in treading this ground, because it might convert the impeachment as a tool of public accountability into a tool for partisan political ends. That has been the concern of some lawyers and some in the IBP, because under our structure now, we have a hyper-presidential system.
Okay.
The Philippines is one of the strongest presidency, Philippines and Argentina. Actually, the power of the purse also belongs to the president, and because the president can impose a budget embargo.
Okay.
So kung sinong presidente, lahat sumusunod. When it was the time of President Ramos, all the congressmen went for Ramos. Time of GMA, all the congressmen went to GMA. Time of ERAP, lahat nata kay ERAP. A time of President Aquino, nandun din kay President Aquino.
So despite now, this, do you think
now the
Chief Justice
will be
given a fair trial?
That is why I think that it would be best for the president to be a little bit more careful in making pronouncements here, because that may prevent the Chief Justice from getting a fair trial, especially with the strong control over the branches of government. And we want the trial to be credible also, the judgment to be credible, so that the people would accept whatever outcome of the trial after the decision is rendered.
Okay. For you, Sonny, I'll give you the last word. Any parting words, particularly to the Filipino public, who will be a witness to history?
Well, thank you, Adele. Like you said, it's a very historic proceeding. It's the first time we're going to be trying a Chief Justice since yung kay Chief Justice Davide hindi natuloy. So I think I'd like the people to participate. I think it will be educational for them. Win or lose, I think it will be good for the country. I think we will emerge stronger as a democracy, as a body politic.
Okay. And on that positive note, I'd like to thank you, Representative Angara.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President, IBP President Juan de Barrios.
Thank you, Adele.
Thank you for joining us. Stay tuned for more.
Thank you.
Perspective.